In industrial applications, pH measurement and control is one of the most critical factors in many processes. In this video, we'll take a look at what pH is and how it can be monitored and controlled in a process. In order to tell the whole story, first we need to know, what is pH? Simply put, pH stands for potential of hydrogen, or the measurement of hydrogen ion concentration in a liquid solution. The logarithmic pH scale ranges from 0, acidic, to 14, alkaline or base, with 7 being neutral. Here are some examples of different substances and where they fall on the pH scale. While pH can be measured using a litmus strip that has been treated with certain chemical powders that, when in direct contact with a solution, change color according to the pH level of that solution. Continuous process monitoring and control of pH, however, requires a more sophisticated approach. pH sensors, commonly referred to as pH electrodes, are designed to allow hydrogen ions in the solution to pass through a selective barrier, generating a measurable voltage differential between the pH measuring electrode and the reference electrode that's proportional to the solution's pH level. For example, at a pH level of 7, which is neutral, the electrodes will produce 0 volts between them. At a lower pH level, acid, a voltage will be developed of one polarity. At a high pH level, caustic or alkaline, a voltage will be developed of the opposite polarity. The electrode is connected to a pH meter, which is basically a high impedance amplifier that accurately measures the minute electrode voltages and displays the results directly in pH units on a digital display. Okay, so we can monitor pH levels in a solution, but what if we want to control those levels? Using our pH electrode and our pH meter, we can adjust pH levels using what's called a reagent. For example, when a high alkaline level is detected, we can bring the pH level down by adding an acid to the solution. Conversely, if a low alkaline level is displayed, a base alkaline solution is added to bring the pH level back up. This is a very simple example and would not be practical on a large scale or where pH adjustments need to be made on a constant basis. But if we use a pH controller in a closed-loop control system like this one, we can automatically maintain the pH level within a predetermined range. In this example of a water treatment system, a pH level of 9 is maintained using carbon dioxide as a reagent. Untreated water flowing into the tank is monitored by the pH electrode. The electrode sends its signal to the controller, where the set point is compared to the incoming electrode signal. If the values change, the controller sends a signal to the control valve that applies carbon dioxide to the tank to control the pH level, thus automating our pH control process. Want to learn more about pH monitoring and control solutions? Check the link in the description for a deeper dive at omega.com.